This is Matthew. He's not the main subject of this story, although he is the reason that we are here. You see, several years ago, Matthew needed a haircut, but no one could get it done. Like a lot of kids with different abilities, he wasn't comfortable in the chair. He was anxious and scared. Then he came here and met him, Billy, owner of Your Kind of Cuts. And everything changed. Matthew got himself a haircut, and Billy, well, Billy discovered his purpose.
How did the mission begin? Was it always just a regular barbershop, or did it become what it is now?
I knew that when I opened the shop that it was going to be geared towards special needs, adults and children, but I never could have fathomed the momentum that we would pick up and where we are today. The identity of our this place changes every day because you never know what you're going to have to do to accommodate somebody.
Look at that. Nice. There we go. Good job. You're okay. Let's do a little bit.
Working with your clients, did you have like a license to do it? Do you have to go to school for it? Or you just kind of just threw yourselves in there?
Neither one of us have any extra official training. I mean, we're both people. There's nothing stopping anybody else from doing what we're doing other than, you know, the lack of effort or intent trying to help somebody.
Come on, how exciting!
Okay, ready? Come on, over here.
Finish.
One, two, three.
I love the challenge aspect of what I do. Yeah. I mean, I could never foresee myself when I went to hair school, you know, helping families the way that I do. I mean, getting a haircut to go on vacation is one thing, but getting a haircut to possibly help some child or an adult through a traumatic situation in the future, that's something different.
Whoa! I love when the kids don't know each other and they start interacting.
Yeah.
And the other one says, "Oh, Benny, it's okay." And then look, and then next you know, they're all playing.
And a high five on the way out. I present to you.
We're gonna do what we have to do. We understand that it's challenging for the parents as well as the kids, and we don't need to do anything to make that any worse.
It has to be so rewarding for you to build the trust, though.
Believe it or not, that starts pretty much every client with the handshake at the door, right? And you kind of, you know, ease their minds a little bit, take some of the nervous tension away from them that they had.
Whoa!
Boys!
That is unbelievable.
I give it 10 out of 10.
Hey! You're watching people grow up. I mean, you are watching.
Absolutely. It's probably one of the happiest results that I can get is watching, you know, clients, whether they be young toddlers or, you know, teenagers or tweens, whatever we're calling them nowadays. You know, it's nice to see them come in, you know, a little uncomfortable from the previous experiences, and, you know, sometimes in a half hour, you know, we're telling jokes and we forget all about the previous barber experience.
And so Billy and Roe keep on cutting, each snip one step closer to a calm outcome. They'll do whatever it takes, never once treating their clients like a burden. Although it's often challenging, you would never know it from their actions or demeanor. Just pure love and understanding. They ease the worries of these kids who already have so much to deal with, so much outside these walls. From the hair on their head to the smiles on their faces. It's humanity, compassion, and of course, a damn fine haircut. Yeah!